Hello children, next to properties of a beta particles, we already discussed in the last class properties of the alpha particles. Next to some of the important properties of the beta particle, and we are comparing with the alpha particle. The first point of the beta particle property is beta particles are the fast moving electrons. These are the fast moving electrons from the nucleus of an atom. It is represented by beta. Next to mass number is 0, next atomic number is -1. Or it is denoted by the electron, mass number is 0, atomic number is -1. Beta particles are the fast moving electrons. It's just like a beta. Beta particles are called as the just electrons which are comes out from the nucleus, not outer, because of the all electrons will be revolving around the nucleus. That orbital electrons is not responsible for this one. Here the beta particles is emitted means the electron is comes out from the nucleus, called as the beta particles. That is the first property. Next, second property is the rest mass of the beta particle. The mass of the beta particle is 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg, which is same similar of that of the mass of the electron, and its charge also minus 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb or minus C. It is a charge of the electron, so that the specific charge, the charge to mass ratio is, it is a very important quantity. So that specific charge means charge per mass or unit mass is, if you calculate the charge is here 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 divided by 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31, then you will get 1.76 into 10 to the power of 11 coulomb per kg. Next, all the both the beta particles and the cathode rays are the fast moving electrons, but they differ in their origin. Even beta particles and the cathode rays means electrons, both the fast moving electrons are same, but they are different in the origin because of the beta particles is comes out from the nucleus of the atom, while the cathode rays means electrons will be comes out from the orbital electron. So that depending upon the origin, it is a different beta particles and charge. Next to electrons, both are the same mass and as well as charge, but they are comes out the based on the origin. If it is comes from the nucleus, it is called as a beta particle. If it is comes from the or surrounding the or moving around the nucleus, orbital electron, it is treated as a means cathode rays means orbital electrons which are revolving around the nucleus. Next property is the speed of the beta particle is approximately in the order of 10 to the power of 8 meter per second, but it is always less than the speed of light. Means 3 to 10 to the power of 8 meter per second, it is the speed of light. Beta particle speed less than that, but in the order 10 to the power of 8 only, not equals to the velocity of the light. It should be less than, so value less than that of the velocity of the light. Different beta particles emit from the same radioactive substance have the different speeds. Even though beta particle emits are emitted by the same radioactive substance, but they have different speeds. Even though the same radioactive substance also the beta particle emits from it, the beta particle speed is different for different times also, and even it comes from the same radioactive substance. Next, beta particles ionize the gas through which they passes. Even the beta particles also, it will be split up into ions when the entirety beta particles is goes through the gas. Next, the ionizing power compared to beta particle and alpha particle and gamma particle. Gamma particle means gamma radiation. The ionizing power of beta particles is roughly 1/100 times that of the alpha particle. Compared to alpha particle, 1/100 times the ionizing power of the beta particle, but nearly 100 times that of the gamma radiation. Here the 1/100 times here, and again, but nearly 100 times compared to gamma radiation, 100 times ionizing power more in the case of the beta particle, but compared to alpha particle, ionizing power little bit less. So that the beta particle's ionizing power is 1/100 times that of the alpha particle, but nearly 100 times that of the gamma radiation. Next, beta particles affect the photographic light. Suppose if you take a photographic light, if you light just touch the entire photographic light, it will capture or produce the image. Even beta particles also falls on the photographic light. ఎషు బీటా పార్టికల్స్ కాస్ ఫ్లూరోసెన్స్ మీన్స్ అట్ లో టెంపరేచర్ ఇట్ ఎమిట్స్ లైట్ మీన్స్ దట్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ యాస్ అ ఫ్లూరోసెన్స్ ఆన్ ఎ స్ట్రైకింగ్ ఎ ఫ్లూరోసెంట్ మెటీరియల్ ఇఫ్ ద ఫ్లూరోసెన్స్ మీన్స్ అట్ ఎ లో టెంపరేచర్ ఇట్ ఎమిట్స్ ద లైట్ వెన్ ఎవర్ ద బీటా పార్టికల్స్ విల్ బి కాస్ ఫ్లూరోసెన్స్ వెన్ ఇట్ పాస్ త్రూ ది ఆర్ ట్రావెల్స్ త్రూ ది ఫ్లూరోసెంట్ మెటీరియల్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఎనీ ఫ్లూరోసెంట్ మెటీరియల్ ద బీటా పార్టికల్స్ ఇస్ పాస్డ్ త్రూ దట్ ఇట్ కాసెస్ ఫ్లూరోసెన్స్ ఫ్లూరోసెన్స్ మీన్స్ అట్ ద లో టెంపరేచర్ ఎమిట్స్ ద లైట్ Next point is the penetrating power of beta particles is more than that of the alpha particles, but less than that of the gamma radiation. The penetrating power in between the gamma radiations and again the alpha particles, they can travel through nearly 5 meters in air. In air, it can travel 5 meters and pass through thin card sheet and even through thin aluminium foil. Card sheet and aluminium foil also it can pass, but 5 millimeter thick, the thickness of the aluminium sheet is 5 millimeter, it stops the entire beta particles. Even it can pass through the 5 meters in air and it can pass through the card sheet with the negligible thickness and even the thin aluminium foil. But 5 millimeter thickness, it will stop, aluminium sheet will be stopped the entire beta particles. Next point is the beta particles are negatively charged. Already you know it is electrons. So the charge of the electron which is equals to the beta particle charge. So they get deflected by the electric and magnetic fields. Beta particles will be deflected with the electric and magnetic fields because of these are the charged particles. The deflection of the beta particles is in the direction opposite to that of the alpha particles. Because of the, you already learned in the case of the electric field and magnetic field, the deflection compared to the alpha particles, so beta particle is exactly opposite. If suppose in the left hand side, alpha particle will be deflected, beta particles are deflected towards right in the case of the magnetic field and electric field in the case of the experiment or activity. Here also the same thing. The deflection of beta particles is in a direction opposite to that of the alpha particles. Since the charge on beta particle is negative while the charge on alpha particle is positive, because what is the reason behind it is beta particle charge is a negative charge compared to the alpha particle. Alpha particle is a positive charge. The deflection of beta particle is more than that of the alpha particle, since the beta particle is much lighter than an alpha particle. Because of the, you can see the experiment, the deflection is more in the case of the beta particle compared to the alpha particle. The reason is beta particle masses are lighter mass, so they are that of the alpha particle. Because of the alpha particle is 4 times proton mass, but electron only single, so that the mass of the beta particle is 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg. Even it is a lighter compared to the alpha particles, so that deflection is more. Beta particles produce X-rays when they are stopped by the metals such as a tungsten of high atomic number and high melting point. High melting point, high atomic number, tungsten filament, the beta particle will be strikes the, or beta particles electrons will be strikes the entire tungsten filament, so that out of that X-rays are produced. X-rays are very very important in the field of any field, even it will give the much more information. So you can practically produce with the help of the beta particles of X-rays. X-rays can be produced with the help of the beta particles in that manner. Next, last point is beta particles cause more biological damage than the alpha particles, as they can easily pass through the skin of our body. So already you know the biological damage in the case of the alpha particle is some effect, but beta particles is little bit higher than that of the alpha particles and it can easily pass through the skin of our body. Our body skin also the beta particle easily passes through that. These are the properties of the beta particles. All of you children, read the textbook carefully, each and every point important. Some of the, we are comparing with the alpha particles and as well as the gamma particles. The properties, some of the, we are comparing with the alpha as well as gamma particles.